Famous Waikiki Beach is once again showing serious signs of erosion. It was only a year ago when tons of sand were brought in to replenish the shoreline.
That cost $2.5 million. So was it money well spent? Manolo Morales has been looking into this. He's live in Waikiki to show us just how bad the problem is. Manolo?
Kathy, this is the beach fronting the Hyatt Regency. And now this fence was just put up by the city late this afternoon. And you can see why. What used to be a lot of sand over here, now a bunch of rocks, jagged rocks, pretty dangerous, some concrete, and they even found rebar over here. The people over here say this is the worst they've ever seen it.
Sometimes the sand would go out and it'd come back, but we've never saw this wall this long before.
Beach boys and regular beachgoers are in disbelief over what's happening to this stretch of Waikiki.
I couldn't believe I was seeing it because there's always been sand here. And then you think about people who are not familiar with the area, tourists and that, they could easily just get knocked into it.
There's some rebar sticking up, you know, pieces of concrete that's just falling into the water, so it can be a hazard.
There is caution tape around the exposed area, but some people tend to ignore it. People here say much of the erosion happened just within the past couple of weeks.
Every time it gets high tide, the sand will go out. Every time. And then, next thing you know, the walls start to show up. You know, and it doesn't look too good.
In April of last year, the state pumped in 24,000 cubic yards of sand from offshore to replenish and widen Waikiki Beach by about 37 feet. The $2.5 million project started from the Duke Kahanamoku statue at Kuhio Beach to past the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. During that time, workers also tore down two rock walls that stretched out into the ocean. Those who know this beach well saying taking those walls away might have caused the erosion to get worse.
There's two walls, and it would trap the sand. Sometimes this wall would get maybe exposed just about up to here, but it always got covered back. But it was never exposed for that length.
The State Department of Land and Natural Resources says the walls were taken down because they were deteriorating and posed a safety hazard. People would climb on them and tend to slip and fall.
Tearing those walls down might have made the erosion worse. I'm still waiting for an answer. Now, in a written statement, the emailed DLNR said it is going to find a solution and work with the city to try and fix this problem. Live from Waikiki, Manolo Morales, KHON 2 News.